Hello, Body Messiah. We're going to be covering a new lesson series, and it's going to be titled with the initials R-I-W, which is Removing Idol Worship. Okay? We're covering lesson one, and in lesson one, this is just a warning for us to remember the warning given in Deuteronomy chapter 18. Okay? So there's a warning that's given, and the reason why I'm being moved to cover this lesson in detail is because we're coming up on a time again in which the Babylonian system is going to be celebrating Halloween, because this is a month of October here in America, probably elsewhere too. And so we in the Body of Messiah have to be conscious as the reason why Adonai Elohim warned us in the Torah about specific things that we see an increase of during this time of this so-called dedicated day for the Babylonian system. We're going to cover this in detail because I think sometimes as people who believe in the Most High God, sometimes with the repetitive and cycles of things that they learn with the Bible, they forget things that are in the Torah. And so this is to refresh them, to understand why it's very vital for us to follow God's commands, ordinances, and standards. In this lesson here, as we cover Deuteronomy 18, we're going to start with verse 10. And with verse 10, you're going to see him specifically, through Moshe, telling the descendants of Israel activities they should not partake in. And there's a reason behind that. But God is letting us know, the descendants of Israel, do not partake in these. And he specifically called them abominations. So I know a lot of times some of these things we'll cover will be taken lightly because you have people who have carnival activities, people who have little Halloween parties, and they love to play act certain things out, okay, that are supposedly scary. But these particular activities could pull you down a rim of idol worship and pull you away from the standards of the Most High God. So let's cover it clearly. The setting of this is where the descendants of Israel are about to go in and overtake the land that God told them to overtake, the land of Canaan. And he's warning them because these activities are pretty common amongst those idol worshipers whose land he is about to drive the idol worshipers out from amongst and allow the descendants of Israel to overtake. So that's a very important point to recognize. As we come through this time of great awakening, we have to let our current and next generation know, just like it was in the days of old, God's standards have not changed. If he's raising up for us for such a time as this, as the prophecy is being fulfilled in Ezekiel chapter 37, we have to be grounded in his standards and his ordinance. That doesn't mean we're going to always be perfect, but we will always teach the whole truth of Adonai's word. So let's begin. Here in verse 10 of Deuteronomy chapter 18, it says, Adonai, through Moshe, is warning the descendants of Israel, there must not be found among you anyone who makes his son or daughter pass through the fire, or a fortune teller, soothsayer, omen reader, or sorcerer, or one who casts spells, or a medium, a spiritist, or one who calls up the dead. We're going to stop right there because it's a lot to cover. In this first section where he's saying no one should make anyone amongst us, none of them should make his son or daughter pass through the fire, there used to be a ritual where they worshiped this statue of this bull, Molech, this idol, and they used to literally pass their children through fires, basically sacrificing their children. This does nothing for the Most High God. He's never asked that of us. Our children belong to him, not an idol, not a worthless idol, a statue, not to Satan either. So it was very vital to understand that majority of those people who were being driven out from amongst the land that God was driving out, they were partaking in this particular abomination. And some of the descendants of Israel were getting pulled down into that arena. Our children belong to the Most High God, just like we do. And so we should never waver from that, Body of Messiah. The objective of Satan or Hasatan is to try to destroy the next generation. That's why we have to do our best to be of sound and sober mind, to keep our eye on our children, to keep them safe and out of harm's way. Remember that portion because we may return to it later on in a future lesson of removing idol worship. It says here that there should be no one amongst us who partake in fortune telling or soothsaying, omen readers. These are people who claim that they can tell your future. Now, if that was true, every single person who calls himself a fortune teller or a soothsayer, omen reader would be the richest people on the planet. There is no such thing. These particular activities right here are not of the Most High God because they distract us as individuals from focusing on Him and His standard. If there's anything we need to know or desire to know about our future or past, we go to Him. We have an open line of communication. By seeking out other avenues that are not of God, you will open yourself up to being deceived and manipulated and abused spiritually, mentally, and physically by the beast system. Okay? I'm going to tell you something about things like this. You know, omen readers, sorcerers, people who cast spells. You see, there's always this increase of people to tap down, dance around these different shows that glorify witchcraft or casting spells. Body of Messiah, you better ingrain it in your children that this is not of the Most High God. There are actual people, and this is not a Disney thing, okay, who believe that they are witches, warlocks, fortune tellers, and they do rituals to idols to glorify Satan in order to so-called be able to cast spells. Never forget what we learned about Balaam or Balaam. Refresh your memory by reading Numbers chapter 24, 25. Remember over and over again, Balaam, who called himself, who was a seer, was trying to cast a spell and curse the descendants of Israel. Adonai would not allow him to do it because he said they are a blessed people and I love them. Okay? There is nothing about any of this that should be a part of the household of Israel. Understand that. Balaam came around in an underhanded way because God would not allow him to, quote, cast a spell or curse the descendants of Israel. And he concocted a plan where another group of people, some ladies, some Midianite and Moabite women, deceived the descendants of Israel and caused them to bow down to these statues and bond with Baal or Peor. So this opened the avenue because when they bow down to worship something that was not of the Most High God and not Him, God had to punish them. So Body of Messiah, don't fall for this foolishness. Okay, the reality is there is nothing of the demonic or satanic realm that has power over us. We belong to the Most High God. Just like He drove out those who were partaking in this practice thousands upon thousands of years ago, He is driving out and destroying them, but we have to hold on to His standard and make sure that we instill this in the hearts and minds of our current and next generation. Remember the lesson to be learned by King Saul, how King Saul was the first king of Israel. And after a while, he began to depart away from the Most High God because he was determined to know whether or not he was going to win a war. And what happened is he turned to the witch of Endor. which caused the Most High God to say, because of your rebellion, I'm going to have to turn my face against you. So he did not hear from God. Saul, King Saul did not. And because of that, he opened himself up to be deceived. Please go look at it in the scriptures. He was deceived by what this witch called herself doing is calling up the dead, a dead prophet, which I do not believe that was the prophet. I believe that was a demonic spirit that caused Saul to be deceived. And because he went down that route, he ended up dying in a way that I don't believe he should have ever died and gone too soon. He should have been humble enough to take his spiritual spanking that the Most High God was giving him. But instead, he went out in a more harsh route because he did not want to listen and he was being rebellious. Do not be deceived by this foolishness. When you see people who call themselves mediums who talk and speak to the dead, if my relatives or my family have passed on and they're in the bosom of Abraham in a resting place until it's my time to go, why, even if you think that's true, would you disturb them? They have no handlings over your life or your world or what's going on with you currently. You have to live your life to the best of your capability until it's your time to move on. These so-called mediums are calling up something, and these things that they're calling up are demonic spirits who are waiting to abuse, mock, and bring you down a path of deception to draw you away from the Most High God. So don't entertain it, body of Messiah. I remember I had a friend back in college who loved when the Halloween time came around and she'd like to have parties and decorate and invite people over to her apartment for it. And this particular time, she called herself was going to pretend she was a fortune teller or also a woman who read tarot cards. And I was like, you know, that's silly. I'm not going to. She was like, why do you got to be a party pooper? Da, 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 da. I said, you know, you can call it what you want to. I said, I got other ways to be entertained, but not that. Okay. It's okay. You know, I said a particular name. I said, but you go ahead and enjoy yourself. This particular friend of mine would always have nightmares of getting attacked, her life being taken, and all these dark dreams. And I remember she would come to me and ask, you know, just pray with me za za za. And I'm like, listen, it comes a time when you got to become spiritually mature and turn your heart wholeheartedly back to the Most High God and His standard. You can't place that on me. That's not my burden. You're the one who are taking a path and going through this turmoil, but God is trying to get your attention. So you need to turn back to Him. And as she began to do that, she began to shake off all of these, what I call, spiritual darkness began to fall off her, and she started losing that spirit of fear, which is very good. And I wish her well. We haven't talked in many, many years. You know, that was over 2 decades or more ago. And I pray that she's doing well. But body of Messiah, we got to understand that this realm opens up you to the demonic to be deceived and abused. So don't have that for our children. Now we're going to hold on and we'll go to the next section of scriptures so we can be very clear as to why God does not want this type of practice amongst the descendants of Israel. Okay, so here's verse 12. And starting with verse 12, you're going to see exactly why Adonai is not going to allow the descendants of Israel to partake in these practices. He says in verse 12, "For whosoever does these things is an abomination to Adonai. And because of these abominations, Adonai, your Elohim, is driving them out from before you. You are to be blameless before Adonai, your Elohim. For these nations, which you are about to dispossess, listen to soothsayers and fortune tellers. But as for you, Adonai, your Elohim, will not allow you to do so. Now, Bani Messiah, I don't know everything behind what it means when our Most High God tells us we will not do so. Okay? God himself is saying he will not allow us to do so. So that's enough for me. I'm too chicken. I fear nothing on this planet or off but the Most High God. He's basically saying, wake up. All of these nations I'm driving out before you partook in this foolishness. And because they wanted to latch on to something that is not of me, the creator of the universe, then that's why I'm dispossessing them and kicking them to the curb out of this land. So Bani Messiah, we have to hold on to God's standard no matter what. I don't want the whipping that our Most High God will give us by being disobedient, number one. But number two, when you see that this leads you down a path of God, the Most High God, our Heavenly Abba, turning his face against us. We will never, ever, never again turn back that route, Bani Messiah. Descendants of Israel, Hebrew descendants of Patriarch Abraham, always hold true. There's only one creator of the universe. He is our all in all. All of this other stuff is just foolishness that can cause us to be in trouble with our Heavenly Abba. Well, Bani Messiah, that's the end of this brief lesson, and I hope you learned something from it. And as I always say to you, may Adonai Elohim cover and surround you and your family, shield and protect you all, and envelop you all with his shalom peace. Goodbye.